Well, I'm professor of environmental resource and ecological economics, and I'm primarily interested in the natural environment and how humans use and potentially conserve the natural environment, and how economic approaches for regulation institutions can help towards achieving more sustainability. So I'm interested in the humans and the relationship between humans and nature. And of course, the oceans are a particularly fascinating part of nature. I think what we as scientists can contribute is to improve the understanding of ocean processes, but also the understanding of economic and social processes that govern how oceans are actually used and treated by humans. And on that basis, maybe propose pathways towards improvement in the management and in the way how we deal with the oceans. So the question, who's actually spending money and effort to achieve those sustainable development goals, right?
Yes.
I think that will remain a tricky question. If you look at, for example, the budget for foreign aid, in the national government spending, the target used to be 0.7% of the government budget, but it's by far not reached in most industrialized countries. And I think if you take this as a proxy for the money or the amount of effort that might go into the sustainable development goals, the conclusion would be rather pessimistic, right? Because the goals are so ambitious, and if you really want to achieve them, we need to do much more effort than spending 0.7% of government budget on this. So I think those are really good and ambitious goals, but I don't really expect that we will achieve them fully in the time spent envisaged. I think many people are really concerned about natural environment, sustainability, and justice. So exactly about the objectives of the Sustainable Development Goals. And there are many people actually spending effort and money towards that direction. Ultimately, I think it is globally people would be willing to put in a significant effort to the benefit of future generations and also the currently living poor people. But there need to be the economic, institutional and social environment where these efforts can indeed yield benefits that are visible to the individuals who spend the efforts. I think when it comes to humans and the prospects for human well-being, we have seen so much development in the past centuries and decades to the benefit of the vast majority of humans on Earth, and I expect that this will by and large go on. So I think that that humans will have a good possibility for good living also in the future. But when we think about the natural environment, and there are particularly about the loss of species, biodiversity loss, then I'm rather pessimistic. So I hope that we will be able to preserve more of the species and preserve more of the natural environment than we would do according to all the business as usual forecasts, but I'm really not sure about it. And of course, that will also be to the harm of future living people, right? Because I would really like to see my grandchildren see similar kind of fascinating things in the ocean and the natural environment as we can. But perhaps they will live in a very different environment. I think they will make the best out of it, and they still have a chance to be happy. But they could be even better off if we do more for the natural environment than we might do if everything goes on as now.